Good morning, 9 a.m. Central Standard Time, 10 o'clock a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and the party has kept going all night long. Do you guys see these bags under my eyes? Seriously, y'all, see? I've been waking up all night to follow this, to comment. So for those of you who are just now tuning in, or you're like, what the heck is going on Lisa's Facebook wall? What is going on? What is going on is the entire automotive community, and then some, because they all want to be in the automotive community after this. We started at midnight last night, Eastern Standard Time, which I had the honor of being able to kick off. We started a prayer-a-thon, as my friend Glenn Lundy would say, a Facebook live-a-thon, which we don't know if it's ever been done yet, to support and to pray for our friends Michelle and Chad. And for those of you who are just catching up, okay, first of all, y'all, I didn't even get to my second cup of coffee yet. I'm wearing my crown because we are all daughters of a Most High King, and I've got the same Wonder Woman shirt that I had on last night because Michelle is our Wonder Woman. But we're here to come together to pray and to support Michelle and Chad. Michelle found out 3 or 4 days ago, she had a lump in her breast, and she kind of delayed going and getting it checked, and I think a lot of women do that out of fear. And the news that came back, it wasn't good. And, you know, and I think part of why people delay things sometimes is because our health insurance system in this country sucks so bad that, you know, they're wondering, you know, how in the world am I ever even going to pay for this? And so, anyways, she had the testing done. She's been super transparent about it. I meant to put her Facebook page on there, but you guys can see it when you go to thefightwithmichelle.com. And she's been chronicling her journey down to her mammogram appointment, then when she had to have the needle biopsy, afterwards, after she told her three sons what's going on. She's just been really transparent and doing a whole video diary of this, but that would make sense because she and Chad are in the video business quick page. They've got a really cool program that helps you communicate with your customers, and it compresses video, and because, you know, the whole world's about video now. We know that, right? Anyways, all of that being said, it was pretty dire, and just, you know, their need for insurance. And luckily, Chad, good job to you. I'm so proud of you that you figured out a way to get at least some sort of insurance. But y'all, it is not even going to begin to cover deductibles and out-of-pocket expenses and Michelle's money or wages for loss of work. And so there was a bunch of us that came together, myself and Glenn Lundy and Sean Hayes and Josh Cummins, Scott Simmons, Ken Walls built a great website for us. My good friend, dear friend, Sherry Matthews has been on the phone offering support. You know, she's the founder of Heal and Comfort, and I can go on and on and on. I wouldn't want to leave anybody off. But as of this morning, okay, so I opened this thing up last night at 11 o'clock or midnight Eastern Standard Time. As of this morning, okay, so last night we were at about $1,600. And as of this morning, we are at 12,000. I'm going to find it. I was so pumped, y'all. I kept waking up last night. I've got the biggest bags under my eyes you've ever seen in your life. Let me see here. Let's see. Let's go to... this thing's tricky because we actually did it over 2 days. So it's like giving me a total from yesterday and today. But as of earlier, we were at about $12,300. So overnight, y'all, overnight, we went from about $1,600 that we had raised that day before we'd ever gone live on our Facebook Live-a-thon to over $12,000, pushing $13,000 now because of the generosity of this automotive community. People that don't even know Michelle and Chad are writing checks. People that know them are writing checks. There are car salesmen all over the country that have committed to donate $5 from every car they sell in the month of August toward this. It's just so amazing. Hold on, I want to get you guys some more stats. And just some of the people, I mean, you know, some of the donations are $5 and some of them are $2,500. And it's just, it's so amazing. And it's so amazing to see everybody come together in groups that we've all started, which is how we met. You know, I met this whole crowd because I was on Sean Hayes' show. And Chad Morgan had reached out to me. He said, "Hey, Sean wants you on his show." So we start becoming friends. And then they, Michelle and Chad, ended up sponsoring my show, The Art of the Big Sell. But between our groups, which is Sales Hustlers, Rise and Grind, The Big Sellers Mastermind, God, you know, I've had like a half a cup of coffee so far today. David Villa's group, the Women in Automotive, Christy Roman and our group. Anyways, there's 35,000 of us that stay in conversation on a daily basis between all of our groups. You see, 35,000 of us. And everybody in this group, the reason all these groups were really formed is because we want to, as the leaders, eradicate bad behavior in the automotive business. We're tired of bullying. We're tired of, you know, all the junk that goes on. So this is not what this is about. But anyways, but that has been our common thread. That has been our common friendships, is that we're all on the same page. And we're all out there trying to say, no, we are really good people. As the automotive industry, we keep this country moving forward. We work hard and we play hard and we give hard and we stand with our own. And this is the first time that all of our groups have come together and all of us have come together and said, we have a friend who needs us. We have a friend that, you know, we cannot alleviate the burden that she and Chad are going through right now, the fear and the fear of the unknown. But what we can help alleviate, see, because I learned a long time ago from somebody who's a lot smarter than me, you can control what you can control. Control what you can control. So what we can control as an automotive community is we can control how much money that we're able to give to Chad and Michelle to help get rid of some of these expenses and to alleviate that financial strain. I mean, not only are you in for the fight of your life, but then you've also got this whole financial side to it. Because I haven't said it 19 times on this video, and I will continue to say it, the healthcare crisis, for lack of a better word, for hardworking Americans that are not on big group policies, it's embarrassing in this country. And that's something that everybody needs to take up and really research. I've got to put my glasses on. I didn't even put my contacts on this morning. I want to see who's on here. All right, we got 29 people on here this morning. Jody DeVere, good morning. Jody DeVere asked Patty in her group. Jody was one of the founding members of the Women in Automotive Conference and one of my very dearest friends and my personal mentor. And I think about, you know, some big decisions I had to make a few years ago. And she sat in my corner and she said, "Lisa, you're going to be bigger than you were when you were a car dealer. You've got big things." And she's somebody that every time something good happens to me, she roots for me. So good morning, Jody. Plus, girlfriend, it's 2 hours earlier out there. You are up, sister. Let's see who else is on. Ken Walls, of course. Ken was so sweet. He jumped in. He is a honorary member of our automotive family. We all love him. We've all been on his show. Josh, Rebecca Contreras, another one of my very, very best friends and absolute prayer warrior. The couple times that I talked about it last night and something recently where I was in dire need of prayer, and Rebecca and David, I mean, they recorded prayers and they sent them to me and they pulled their boat over and all of our friends prayed. We were not out there with them. And there is something for a praying friend, I'll tell you, or 35,000 praying friends. You know, and Michelle, I brought this up for you, honey. This was my license plate when I sold my car dealership, and I bought it and I put it on my car. No, I didn't have a car. I bought it prior to even selling the dealership because a friend of mine called me to her house, Jan Goss Gibson, and she said, "Lisa, I've been praying for you." See the common thread here, guys? When our friends pray, stuff happens. She goes, "I've been praying for you this morning, and God told me to tell you to fear not." That is the word that kept coming to me, is to fear not. That whatever your next steps are going to be, this was 3 years ago, whatever your next steps are going to be, that God is with you. And you are going to have more impact. You're going to have more influence than you've ever had in your life. So walk away from the four walls in Austin, Texas, and go out and go global. And you know what? I believed it so much, y'all, that I went home and I ordered this plate for a car that I didn't even own yet. You see, when our praying friends speak into us, when they tell us that they've heard from God, and when Rebecca Contreras hears from God, or Jan Goss, or Renee Bangelsdorf, or Angel Goff, or any of my other friends, when they hear from God, I listen. Because a lot of times, so many times, because I think Sometimes we can be so in the fire, right? We can be so consumed with fear that God uses other people to speak in us and through us. That's how God rolls. And so this morning, you know, as I'm all night long waking up, watching what's going on, because I'm the one who set up the GoFundMe, so I get to hear the ding, 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 ding every time we get a donation, whether it's $5 or $2,500, every single dime is blessed. And every single dime that you guys have done is absolutely appreciated. It kept ringing in my head, ringing in my head. And I wonder if this is how my friend Jan felt. And it was like, Lisa, you go get that plate. And that's why I'm up here and not outside doing it. So I'm getting ready to go to the trail. And it is to fear not. That you have to tell Michelle, it is to fear not. See, fear not is used in the Bible more times than anything else. That's what Jesus says. It's to fear not, because it doesn't do us any good to fear. It isn't going to change the outcome. The only thing that changes the outcome is if we pray and if we have faith. And I know that Michelle and Chad have big faith. And so I really thought about what kind of prayer I'd want to give. And so I just want to ask everybody now to pray. But something that is really, really heavy on my heart is that, dear God, we need to pray for Michelle's doctors. Because when you're in a fight like this, and when you... you know, that they need wisdom for the right treatment. You know, there are so many ways to get treatment, right? There's the Western, there's the Eastern, there's prayers. I believe personally that you need them all. And God's just telling me that she needs everything. She needs everything to fight for her life. And God, I just want to just lift up to you, Michelle and Chad and all these people that are on today, that we know that she is a daughter of the highest King. And that you have got your arms around her. You can see you're allowing this thing to manifest. You're allowing everybody to share. You're allowing all of these donations to come in today, because I believe, and I'm going to say, I believe that there's a testimony here. There's a testimony within the automotive industry. We know that there's 35,000 eyeballs at any given time during this 24-hour Facebook live-a-thon that are going to see the testimonies and the faithfulness of your people. And God, we are believing for at least $50,000 to be raised. We originally were at $10,000, but why would we ever go small when we have a big God? Why would we ever go small when we have a big God? And I just heard another ding come in from another donation. And God, you have put it on my heart today to tell Michelle through you that you are to fear not, that you have got this. You've got a testimony. You've got a story. You're going to come through this with flying colors. God, we are going to pray for her doctors as they lay out a treatment plan that will heal you, that will and will give you what you need to be able to continue to take care of your family, to be able to take care of your business, and to be able to tell your story and document it, because you are so brave, Michelle. That is such a brave thing to do, is to document it and to share it with people, because you will save lives. Nothing's going to take your life, Michelle. Your testimony is going to save lives. And so, Lord, I just put that out there for everybody that's out there praying this morning, that the word and that keeps coming to me is, Michelle, you are to fear not. Amen. And another donation just came in. I mean, what a cool thing this is. I'm serious. I mean, like, I'm a pretty big sleeper when it comes to, I need to be in bed at 10 o'clock at night, and I'm a solid sleeper till 5:30 or 6 o'clock in the morning. And I slept with my telephone. My husband's at the ranch this weekend, and I slept with my telephone. I kept the ringer on. Ding, ding, ding. I'd wake up again. I want to see what's going on Facebook, because that's who we are as a community. We happen to be in the people business, and our business is selling cars. Our business is supporting car dealerships. You know, we have car dealers on here, Josh Cummins and Scott Simmons. And I mean, you know, all these guys own the places, and they're in our communities. They're our friends. And we have everybody in between. And we have people that sell cars. We have a gal that was just on last night. She was so sweet. She's like, I'm just a stay-at-home mom, but I got in the car business 6 months ago. No, you're not just a stay-at-home mom. You're a prayer warrior. You're somebody who came out and you supported your friend. Ding, ding, ding. We just got another donation. I've heard four dings while we have been on this. I mean, I don't even know what to say. Alexander just donated, and Carol just donated, and Jason just donated, and Tammy just donated, and Kenneth just donated, and Jake just donated, and Subaru Steve Montgomery just donated, and Rebecca Chernick. I mean, guys, we're not in this alone. You know, that's the beautiful part about community. You know, if this doesn't convince every single person out there that you need to be a part of something bigger than yourself, you need to be part of a community, that you need to give more than you expect. You know, when Chad and Michelle offered to sponsor my show and get all my deliverables ready and talk to my show guests, you know, I started this show called The Art of the Big Sell on Mondays. Because if anyone knows me, I'm the least technical human in the world. You know, I don't know anything about graphic design. I mean, what I know how to do is to get on camera and talk to people because I love people so much and I love to tell other people's stories. Okay, that is my superpower, but the rest of it, not so much. Anyways, they were amazing, fantastic. And you know, they didn't charge me a dime, not a dime. You know, so they used their resources to help build my show. They never asked me for money. They never asked me for anything. What happens when you are that kind of servant business leader? When you own a company and you think, you know what, I'm going to jump in on this deal with you. I you know, I believe in you. Then what happened? And I know mine is one of just a gazillion stories. Because as I woke up to these bags under my eyes, as I woke up all night long listening to the stories of Chad and Michelle, it's the same story over and over and over again, that they are servant leaders, that they give back. Another servant leader just jumped on, my very dear friend, Ken Walls. You know, we had a GoFundMe link, and we didn't even ask Ken to do this, but he was worried that possibly Facebook would shut us down, or I'm not quite sure exactly what he's worried about. I think I heard that in one of the 4 million messages on Messenger, as this whole team of us are going through and having conversations about this, about how this was going to go off. And so he took it upon himself to go build a website, fightwithmichelle.com. That's fightwithmichelle.com. And he tied the GoFundMe account to it. And again, I don't even know how you do that. Ken does all of my technical stuff. Ken does all of my websites for Cars Her Way, for lisacopeland.com, for everything. I don't do anything without Ken. But he just did that out of the goodness of his heart. I didn't ask him to do that. On top of the fact, he has donated over $300. I'm not trying to single any one person out, because every one of you, just by showing up, is doing something. Every one of you, just by you know, sticking your y'all, from a stage I'd do a lot better. But saying out loud that I support this, I am praying, I am here. You guys are sending hearts, you're sending love. Here came another donation. Jared, thank you so much, love. You know, they just keep coming in just by the fact that you guys are on here on a Sunday morning. You don't have to be on here. We got 25 people out there. Share this, y'all. Please, please share this, because that's another donation just came in, y'all. Unbelievable. Okay, let's see here. Gail, no one should have to worry about the financial expenses when going through times like this. I'm telling you, we need to clean house in frickin' Congress. Clean house. You know, our friends in Canada, who some of my friends were on here last night, and they donated. They're not in the automotive industry. They're just my friends, Chantal. In Canada, they don't have these worries in Canada, okay? And don't start me on socialist versus capitalist and all of that. It doesn't matter, okay? Anyways, I'm not going to go there. I know part of the reason why the U.S. can't have the healthcare system it needs, but we have to do something in this country. We can't have Americans that are paralyzed, that they are one diagnosis away from bankruptcy. Okay, we can't do that. Not everybody is as lucky as Michelle and Chad to have the community of over 35,000 automotive professionals that are willing to jump in, that are willing to, you know, there's all these car salesmen out there, tons of them. And they've all said, for every car I sell in the month of August, I'm going to donate $5 per car. Wow. And people want to talk about car salesmen? We want to see those memes about how car salesmen are lower than Congress? Oh, no, not on my watch. I started out as a car salesman, okay, 30 years ago. I was like 12. I was the youngest car salesman in the world. And those car salesmen, to me, they're the most important cog in the automotive industry. Without them out there sacrificing in the hot, in the cold, doing everything that they have to do, none of us would move forward. When I was a car dealer, I had such respect for my team, for my salespeople. But the rest of the world wants to say bad things about car salesmen. Oh, they're so this and they're so that. Well, hey, America, We have car salesmen out there that have committed in the month of August to give $5 of every car they sell to help support Michelle and Chad and help them get through this fire that they happen to be in right now. Now, I believe to my very soul that they're going to come through it with this giant testimony. And I mean, we even had news, CBS, somebody reached out last night. I don't know, Glenn Lundy's going to handle that, the media, because nobody's ever seen this before. So all of us lowly car people, I hope it shows the rest of the world that we're not that. That we are not in the car business, that we're in the people business. And that when things get tough, when things get tight, whenever happens, that we know how to mobilize. We mobilized in 8 hours, y'all. So this is a 24-hour telethon, Facebook live-a-thon. It's 24 hours. We needed 48 people to start at midnight last night, which I told you I was the opening one and Lundy was the second one, and go all night long. Y'all, we went all night long and raised over $12,000 in the middle of the night. What are we going to do as we continue to go up until midnight tonight, Eastern Standard Time? You see, we went in originally at $10,000. And then once we hit it at, I don't know, 2 o'clock in the morning or something, we're all going back and forth. They're like, Lisa, raise it. Hey, another donation just came in. Yes. They're going, Lisa, you need to raise it. Because you know why? That was like us putting a fence around God. Here came another donation. That was like us putting a fence around God. That was like us saying, well, all we can do is $10,000. Well, we're going to do whatever God wants us to do. Because this is a chance to have a testimony to 35,000 people between all of our groups. This is bigger than Michelle and Chad. This is bigger than Michelle and Chad. And that's what kept coming over me this morning also. This is going to, you know, just the fact that news agencies are seeing this and, you know, they want to know more about it. Well, what would be the good news that they would spread? Not only is the automotive industry faithful to their own, but just the fact that the automotive industry is a good place and that they believe in God. Yes, we believe in God. We are not slimy plaid suit car salesmen. We are real people trying to make a living just like everybody else, right? Let's see what some of my peeps out here have to say. Okay, y'all, you're good because we only have 8 more minutes of me. And then after that, I'm turning it over to Mr. Rick Berman. As you guys can see up here, I've got a link to Rick. So as soon as I'm done in 8 minutes, then you want to click out and go over to Rick because we got to keep this thing rolling. We just have got to keep it rolling. And I heard Lundy talk about this morning, I was watching, and, you know, it was all about, you know, in the old days, you know, you'd have a telethon and you'd see all kinds of people with their, you know, behind you and they're on the phones and you have to call in. You don't have to do that anymore. It has never been easier to stage a miracle. It's never been easier to stage a miracle. Most of the people that have donated do not know Michelle and Chad. That's a fact. Most of the people that donated, we all somehow came together on this crazy string through Sean Hayes. And guess what? Sean Hayes is just a car salesman. Or he was. He got promoted going on to Dan Cummins Chevrolet. But when I met Sean, Sean was just a car salesman who was committed. Here, got another donation. Woohoo! Eric Payne, thank you. Yes. Yes. I want to be a fundraiser. God, I love this. Like, I'm so pumped up right now. I haven't even had a whole cup of coffee yet. I'm good for 3 of these in the morning, just so you guys know. Another one just came in. God, I feel like Jerry Lewis right now on the telethon. I can hardly stand myself. Jason Rice. Thank you, Jason. You rock. Mike Phillips says, don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will hold you up and with my victorious right hand. Let's see what else is out here. Sherry Matthews, Michelle's journey will save lives. Gail, 365 times. It's in the Bible, once for every day of the year. Fear not. That's right. That's it, baby. So the rest of the story behind this plate was, so I had it. So I bought it before I even had a car. I had a car. I had 600 cars. I was a car dealer. Okay. But I went and I ordered it from the Texas DMV because you can do that when you order personalized plates. And I went down to pick it up. I still hadn't even sold my dealership yet. I went down and I picked it up. And the lady at DMV is like, okay, what car are you going to register this to? And I go, I don't have a car to register it to. She's like, huh? And I'm like, I will have a car. But this was the first step that I needed to know that that was God's plan for me, was to step out, to sell, and to go out and be an influencer in the world. And if I could just, I can't even tell you the doors I've been through, but some of you follow me, you guys know, in the last 2.5 years, how my life has blown up, how my business is just off the chain, the people that I've met, the influence that I feel like I've had, not only in the automotive industry, but elsewhere, all because I chose to listen to and believe a message that I know that was given to her from God himself. Here comes another donation, y'all. Another donation, AJ Anderson. Let's keep going with these donations. We got 5 more minutes on my watch. I'm a little bit competitive, y'all. I want this 10 o'clock to 10:30 time slot to be absolutely off the chain, to raise the kind of money that the faithful will come through. You know, Lundy said it yesterday, you know, what are you going to spend this week on Starbucks, which is the world's most overpriced coffee? I don't buy it, y'all, just saying. What are you going to spend this week on lunch? How about pack a lunch, bring it to work, and give us the $10 for a week. Make that commitment that you would have spent on your lunch. Bring it. Donate it. I promise you, that peanut butter and jelly sandwich will never taste so good Monday through Friday when you sit and eat it, because you're going to know that that other lunch was given to help our friend be victorious and build her testimony. Okay, so back to Fear Not. So it was up about 3 months ago on my car, and my husband said, "What are you?" Because in Texas they're good for 2 years. And my husband said, "Are you going to renew it?" And I said, "I don't need to anymore. I don't walk in fear anymore. I don't walk in the worry of what's going to happen if I walk out of this high profile position. No, I'm fierce now." So my new license plate that isn't here yet, it should be here next week, is fierce. And there's more to it than that. It's not about me, but I'm just saying. So, you know, there are certain stages in our life where we walk in fear, and we need a friend to tell us it's time to fear not. And that's how God uses our friends, our true friends. That's how God uses them, to give us a word. But I also knew it was time to no longer fear, to take this thing off my car. It did for me what it needed to do. Okay, this was the crutch. It's purple, everything. And I'd look at my car and I'd be like, you know what? Fear not. Doesn't matter what I go try to do. Doesn't matter the biggest meetings I've walked into now. Fear not. If it's meant to work out, it'll work out. If it doesn't, it doesn't. I've been lucky. It's worked out. Okay. Fear not. Michelle, fear not. I need to send you. I've got 2 of these plates. I'll send you one, girlfriend. Anyways, guys, it's about time for my time to be up. Put my glasses on. I have contacts now, just so you guys know, but I was too lazy to put them in this morning. Okay, so we're at 3 minutes left. Excuse me. Sherry Matthews, car salesman rule. Yes, they do. Let's see. Jeffrey, yes, ma'am. I am heading that up. Okay, I'm challenging every salesman in the biz. Okay, so guys, Jeffrey Lee Parton, he is heading that up. I keep seeing all these pictures that have Michelle's picture on it, mine included. I'm so confused. I'm like, oh, is Michelle on here? No, we've all got Michelle's picture in our Facebook picture. So anyways, for those of you who want to be part of that movement, reach out to Jeffrey Lee Parton. He's putting together the $5 per car. And for those of you not in the car business, support the dealerships. Support the people. I saw Chris Martinez on here earlier from Charles Mon Toyota. Here in my town, they're my clients, and they're hosting a huge event for me to celebrate Sherry Matthews. She won the 2018 Global Women's Inspiration Award for her work with breast cancer survivors. And I use the word survivor. There are no victims. A survivor. Michelle, you are a survivor. You're going to have a testimony. 35,000 people are going to, or and more, probably millions, are going to follow you on this journey of survival. I just pray that you listen to your doctors, that you seek the medical treatment that you need, and you have faith, faith over fear, girl, faith over fear, because I know that you've got this, and God has got your back, as do all of us in the automotive industry. It looks like my time is up. You guys go up here. Rick Berman. Rick, thank you. I am passing the baton, my friend. Keep donating. Ding, 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 ding. Keep donating. All right. Love you guys. Bye-bye. Oh, and P.S. I'll be on Lundy's show tomorrow morning at 4:30 Central Standard Time, 5:30 Eastern Standard Time, so that we can, at his Rise and Grind show, so that we can give every one of you miracle updates, testimony updates, and a drum roll on how much money we raised. Mwah. Bye, y'all.